I'm in the hall, excited about my first day on Raw, and Batista gets in my face, accusing me of laughing at Triple H when he got drafted to SmackDown. Before I can even address it, Triple H cheap shots me.
First rule on Raw, Sheldon, never disrespect a game.
I'll tell you what, Eric, I want a match tonight against Triple H.
I'll tell you what, Sheldon, be careful what you wish for, because you're going to get it.
Welcome to Raw, Sheldon Benjamin. The game is ready to teach Sheldon Benjamin a lifelong lesson.
You go out there, you show Triple H where you come from, what you represent. Take Triple H down. It's your time, man.
Damn right.
What an opportunity for Sheldon Benjamin to make his mark here on Raw.
He's going
to
get massacred, I can assure you of that, JR. What do you think?
Now, there you go. Sheldon Benjamin showing you he's not intimidated.
Oh, get up, wipe that smile off his face, Triple H.
Chief shot, damn it! Damn it!
Stay in your corner, Benoit. You leave that alone.
Oh, splash in the corner. And the roll up, the cradle, will it? No! What? Sheldon Benjamin, that's not right, has just hit the game. Well, we all know that Triple H is a big money player. No. Tonight, King, this was all about the Benjamins.
Welcome to Monterrey, Mexico.
WWE in Monterrey.
The first time WWE is here, and this is great.
These guys are really enthused about the WWE being here. A total mob scene here, which is something I got to get used to, but I'm loving every minute of it. The fans here are great.
We are live!
To reach out to another fan base. It was really a tremendous night. I'd definitely come back.
We are live tonight in Houston, Texas, still to come. It will be Triple H versus Sheldon Benjamin in the rematch. Oh. And no one allowed at ringside.
I can't wait for that match. It's going to be tremendous to see that young punk get that smile slapped off his face.
But I can't wait for Backlash. I can't wait to see Mick Foley, the legitimate hardcore legend, a man that put his body through everything, challenge Randy Orton for the Intercontinental title. Mick Foley, we know, he's a little crazy. He's a maniac. And Mick Foley's going to get his hands on Randy Orton and Backlash. Now, there's Mick Foley is with us, ladies and gentlemen.
And not worn in the last 10 years until just a few days ago, I went through a box of my favorite things and gleefully withdrew it, intending to wear it in my match at Backlash in Edmonton. That may sound funny that a guy whose name is synonymous with hardcore wrestling would become so fond, even in love, with an inanimate object. But I've always found the word hardcore really had nothing to do with chairs. It had nothing to really do with tables, garbage cans, cookie sheets. The name hardcore signified that I had an attitude that meant I was going to go above and beyond what it took to give the fans the greatest show possible. It was a word that said, I love the business and I love the fans enough to put my body through unimaginable pain. And even when I had the chance to go to Japan and take part in some barbaric matches, I did it with love on my mind. After all, in 1994, I had a one-year-old baby girl. I had a three-year-old boy. I had a mortgage to pay, and I did what I had to do to pay the bills. So even though some of the matches I took part in may have been described as inhumane, deep down in my heart, I rested with the comfort and the knowledge that I was doing it for love. And I swore I'd never go back. I swore I'd never watch those matches again, never watch what I put those poor Japanese people through. But in trying to recapture the fire and the passion that I thought I lacked at WrestleMania, I went back and I looked at the tapes. And I did barbaric things. I did inhumane things. But it wasn't the moves. It wasn't the barbed wire. It wasn't the tacks that caught my eye. It was my eyes. Over and over, I'd watch the tapes, rewind, play, rewind, play. And it was there. It was a look in my eyes that said deep down, maybe there was a little part of me that didn't mind inflicting that type of damage. Deep down, maybe there was a little part of me that even liked it. Deep down, when I heard the screams, the suffering, the agony, maybe, maybe deep down, I even loved it. Randy Orton, these were honorable men. Nice men. They never spit in my face. They never conducted a calculated campaign calling me a coward. They never took cheap shot triple team efforts to send me to the hospital. But the fact is, when I had the chance, I wrapped the arm in barbed wire and I tore them apart. So if I were you, I'd be asking myself a simple question, and that question would be, then what the hell is this man going to do to me at Backlash, knowing full well he hates my guts? The answer, Randy Orton, is simple. I am gonna kick your ass all over it. No. I'm not gonna kick your ass all over Edmonton. Because I hear that all the time. It's become cliche. I'm gonna kick your ass, man. I'm gonna kick your ass. I'm not going to kick your ass in Edmonton, Randy. I'm going to be a little bit more descriptive than that. And in order to be descriptive, well, I'm going to have to introduce you to another old friend of mine. Another friend I saw in my box of favorite things, Randy Orton. Say hello to my friend, Barbie. And Barbie's not going to kick your ass. Barbie is going to get sunk into your skull, and I'm going to carve caverns of gore into your virgin flesh. I'm going to bring on the type of bleeding usually reserved for special effects teams in Mel Gibson biblical efforts. Randy Orton, I am going to tear you apart. I'm going to take Barbie, and I'm going to be off. I'm going to take Barbie, and I'm gonna take Barbie. I'm gonna teach you what it means to be hardcore. I'm gonna rip. I'm gonna tear. I'm gonna gorge. I'm gonna possibly disembowel. And I'm going to love it.
You say love it?
Hey. It's gonna be all right, kid. Come here. Hey. You're Randy Orton. He's always talking big. He can't do anything to you. You're the Intercontinental Champion. You're part of Evolution. You know what? Mick Foley's out of his mind anyway. Don't ever think this. Huh? Hey, champ.
I'm gonna take that punk kid.
We know you are, man.
You don't mess with the game.
Hey. Watch this, watch this. Always confident. Always confident. Always confident. Go get a game!